Meltdowns of nuclear reactors happened before Chernobyl. One of them was in Leningrad, in the USSR. The other was in Three Mile Island, in the USA. Could the Soviet Union draw some conclusions from both of them? Definitely. But did they? No. And if they did, maybe the Chernobyl disaster could have been avoided. Hello all and welcome. Today marks the start of our new series, The People of Chernobyl. Well, actually we have already made a few of these videos before, but we organized them into a separate playlist, so you could easily navigate through our channel when seeking some particular information. Today, we will focus on Valery Legasov, a famous physicist who already got his own episode earlier this year, but this time we are going to introduce you to a longer miniseries in which we will explain his background and, of course, his role in the Chernobyl disaster. To do so, we have to slowly start by refreshing some of the information we already published in many other episodes, but I think that's important when we face a longer, in-depth miniseries about a particular person. So, what do you say we will start? Let's go! The People of Chernobyl, Valery Legasov. Part 1. The Introduction. One might think that the USSR has been completely detached from the rest of the world. This is a false impression. Maybe most of its citizens had very limited contact with anything from outside the Iron Curtain. Nonetheless, the USSR knew how and when to use any information about the rotten West. So we might say that the USSR and Warsaw Pact countries were in fact informed about different events around the globe, but most often the news was censored to ensure that they would draw the right conclusions. Regarding nuclear power, one of the most infamous accidents happened in the US. At the Three Mile Island Nuclear Generating Station, or just Three Mile Island. Located in Pennsylvania, 130 kilometers from Philadelphia and Boston, 225 kilometers from New York, the nuclear power plant suffered a partial meltdown in 1979 and was widely reported. But not in the USSR. I think this is one of the best indicators of how the Soviet citizens were informed about many various topics. The USSR officials decided to largely censor the news about Three Mile Island. Not because they were sympathetic to the US and the people who suffered. Oh no. They feared that this information, despite it could cast a dark shadow over their rival, the USA, could spark a fear of nuclear energy on their territories also. An energy that was crucial to the failing USSR economy. Jimmy Carter, the US president at the time, served in the US Navy as a nuclear engineer himself and visited the scene of the accident to slow down the anti-nuclear movements across his nation. The USSR officials feared these movements could cross their borders too. Publicly, the Soviet officials pointed out the rotten capitalism as the cause of the Three Mile Island accident. While Chernobyl has been active for 2 years and building more units to house more reactors, the Ukrainian Minister of Energy, Vitaly Skliarov, underlined in one interview that Soviet technology is so advanced, the odds of a meltdown similar to the one in the USA were minimal, 1 in 10,000 years. That was a few years before Chernobyl accident, and 4 years after a classified partial meltdown in Leningrad. And during this time, one of the most important people in the whole Chernobyl disaster story revealed himself to the wider public. An academician, immediate deputy of Anatoly Alexandrov of the Kurchatov Institute. His name was Valery Legasov. Despite being active in the nuclear energy field for years, Legasov stepped into the spotlight more after he published an article insisting that what happened in the USA was not related in any way to the Soviet projects. He pointed out that the operators in nuclear power plants across the USSR were better trained, better prepared, and their overall safety standards were light years ahead of those in the USA. After creating the long miniseries on the RBMK design and history, the last sentence sounds exactly like the propaganda the USSR was feeding its citizens on a daily basis. If you watched it, you probably have the same feeling. And if you haven't, I encourage you to do so later. The published article was one thing. It was following the official narrative. But privately, many Soviet scientists, or precisely speaking, physicists, started to analyze the risks of similar event happening in one of the USSR's nuclear power plants. They started to revise the safety regulations and assessed the likelihood of particular problems emerging in the Soviet state. Nonetheless, Nikiet and Sredmash, the two most important organizations dealing with nuclear power projects in the USSR, have failed to make any important moves. Just to remind you, in the 1970s, USSR was developing its new reactor, the RBMK. Despite proving itself unpredictable and even dangerous, officials didn't see the necessity to improve that design. The meltdown in the first RBMK operating nuclear power plant happened in Leningrad in 1975. But the official reasons were false. They blamed the manufacturing defect, not their whole reactor design. So, after the Three Mile Island, which happened 4 years later, one might think that the USSR specialists should take care of their own risks and problems. They didn't. The political system was such corrupted in so many ways, the need for public applause and support was more important than the real achievements. So often the projects were reported as success, while they sometimes didn't even start. In this environment, nobody should be surprised that not Nikit nor Sredmash put any interest in bringing the RBMK reactor into line with the new rules. Rules that the Soviet scientists worked on after hearing about the US tragedy. Valery Legasov was at the center of these events, and he was already an influential scientist and an important person in the world of nuclear physics in both the USSR and all the Allied nations of the Warsaw Pact. Born on September the 1st, 1936, exactly 3 years before the Second World War, he was the son of civil workers. The city of Tula, where he was born, about 170 kilometers from Moscow, was one of the more important places in the USSR, at the time housing machinery and weaponry factories, as well as a military school. Having in mind his background, we can be pretty sure Legasov was not born into a wealthy family, but he wasn't also a son of a poor couple. They had enough money to support his education, which was crucial for his future career. He was sent to school in Kursk, then quickly moved to Moscow, which at the time was something that could give a hint about both his loyalty to the system and a talent for science. He studied there for 6 years, from 1949 to 1954. I hope this short introduction will make a good start for the new miniseries about Valery Legasov. You may hear more about Valery in another episode, which covered his early years and education. Save the link from the upper right corner for later. As always, leave a comment if you want to hear some specific information about the famous scientist. I will try to prepare and include it in the next videos. That's it for today, guys. Take care. Stay safe, and see you next week.